Hello everyone, this is Savita Acharya from Kendra Engineering College. In this video lecture, we'll look into a few exercise problems of module 4, that is behavioral modeling. Question number 9, using the weight statement, design a level sensitive latch that takes clock and D as inputs and Q as output. Q equal to D whenever clock is equal to 1. So the block diagram of this would be, say, let me take the module name as D latch. Okay, output input is clock and D, and output is Q. So the condition is you have to use the wait statement. Module D latch clock D and Q, input D and clock, output Q, and Q also should be declared as register. Okay, next, always I will use the wait statement. Wait clock Q equal to D. So meaning of this is always wait for clock equal to 1. Whenever clock is equal to 1, latch this output to input. Okay, this is the program, that's it. Here I have the block diagram of the D latch with the D clock as inputs and Q as the output. We'll proceed to write the test bench for this module. So module D latch underscore TB. There are empty parentheses. There are no ports because there are no ports that are going to interact with the external world. Okay. I'll declare D and clock as registers and Q as wire. Okay, now I will have an initial block where I will have some initializations. So I will initialize clock to 0 first and then D to 1, and after a delay of say 20 time units, I will make D equal to 0, and say after a delay of 120 time units, I will make D equal to 1 again. So this completes the initial block. Now I will have an always block to generate the continuous train of clock pulses, that is hash 10 clock equal to not of clock. That means for every 10 time units, the clock will be toggled. So this completes the, so this always block will generate a clock with the time period equal to 20 time units. We'll see how the output will occur here, appear here. Say what I've done is I have generated a continuous train of clock pulses. So it is the clock period is 20. Pulse period is 10 here. So clock period will be 20. D is 1 initially. And after 20 time units, that is after 1 clock period, it is becoming 0. And after 120 time units, that is previous time is 20. 20 plus 120, that is at 140, again output will be, sorry, Q D is made as 1. Now output here initially the clock is 0, so the output is undefined. When clock becomes 1, the output is latched, input is latched to the output. Okay, so when clock is becoming 1, the D value is 1, so Q also becomes 1. Now next clock is becoming 0, but the output will be latched to the previous value itself. So 1 is the previous value, that same thing will be latched. But actually D had become 0 here. So next when clock becomes 1 here, that new value of D will be latched to the output. So since D is retained at 1 for a longer period, that will go on latching the output as well. Okay. Now actually at say 140, here d is becoming 1, but that is not reflected at the output because the clock is 0 here. Next clock becomes 1 here. So when clock becomes 1, the new value of d, that is 1, is latched to the output. So this is how the latch works. Next question. Design the 4:1 multiplexer by using if and else statements. Okay. So we'll first draw the block diagram of the 4:1 multiplexer. So the 4:1 multiplexer, I will take the module name as MUX41. Okay. And there are 4 inputs, I0, I1, I2, and I3. 2 select lines S1 and S0 and 1 output. Okay. So the condition is you have to use if and else statements only. Module MUX41 I0 out I0 I1 I2 I3 S0 and S1. Okay. The ports are input I0, I1, I2, I3, S0 and S1, and output is output port is out. Output out. Okay. Next, we'll have to declare out as a register because if and else statements come in behavioral modeling. So always add, so we'll take the sensitivity list as all the inputs I0, I1, I2, I3, S0 and S1. Now inside the always block, we'll use the if statement. If, now we have to check, I'll just write the block diagram, a truth table, S1, S0 and out. If S1, S0 is 0, 0, I0 will be transferred to the output 0, 1, I1, 1, 0, I2 and 1, 1, I3 will be transferred to the output. So I have to check if S1, S0 is 0, 0, then I have to assign I0 to output. So what I'll do is I will concatenate S1 and S0. Now this becomes a 2-bit vector. So I can check now if S1 S0 is equal to 2 tick D 0, then out equal to I0. Okay. Then similarly, I can write the other conditions, else if S1 S0 is equal to 1, that is 2 tick D 1. 0, 1 can be written in decimal as 1. In that case, out equal to I1. Next, else if S1 S0 concatenated is equal to 2 tick D 2. Sorry, this equal to operator is double equal to. Single equal to is the assignment operator. So double equal to 2 tick D 0, then out equal to I2. And the last case remaining is you can use the else statement. So out equal to I3. So end and end module. So we have written the 4:1 multiplexer using if else statements. Now to write the stimulus block, I have written the block diagram here for the 4:1 multiplexer, and also I have written a few essential lines of the test bench, that is module MUX41_TB, empty braces. Then I have declared all the input ports of the module to be tested as registers and output as wire. I have also instantiated the 4:1 multiplexer by connection by order. And inside the initial block, I need to apply the test vectors. Okay. So first I will do one-time assignment for the inputs. That is, first I will assign I0 equal to say 0. And I1 equal to 1 and I 2 equal to say x and I3 equal to say z. Okay. And also I will assign, I will concatenate and assign S1, S0 to 0, to tick D 0. Now, after a delay of say 20 time units, I will change the select line, application of the select line, I will make it as 1. Then after a delay of say 20 time units, I will apply S1, S0 as 2. Similarly, after a delay of 20 time units, S1, S0 as 3. And simply for curiosity, I will just put S1, S0 after a delay of 20 time units as again 1. Okay. This completes the initial block and the module, test vector or test bench module. So this is the waveform for the 4:1 multiplexer. The test bench that we have written for testing the same is also shown here. So here, initially what I have done is I0 I have initialized to 0, I1 1, I2 x and I3 z. This is one time assignment. I0 is 0, I1 is 1, I2 is x and I3 is z. Okay. Now S1, S0 initially I have initialized to 0. So S1 is 0, S0 is 0. So output will be equal to, at t equal to 0, output will be equal to I0. So I0 is 0. So 0 will be the output. Next, after 20 time units, what I have done is I have initialized, assigned S1, S0 to 1. So 0, 1. So this is 1. So it will be equal to I1. I1 is 1, so output goes to 1. Next, S1, S0 is 2, that is 1, 0. So it will be equal to I2. I2 is x, so x is denoted as red here. That will be passed on to the output. Finally, S1, S0 is 3, that is 1, 1. In that case, it will be equal to I3. That is blue color thing, that is high impedance, that will be output to the output port. Okay. So that is how we have to visualize the waveform. Question number 11. Using a case statement, design an 8 function ALU that takes 4 bit inputs A and B and a 3 bit input signal select and gives a 5 bit output out. The ALU implements the following functions based on a 3-bit input signal select. Ignore any overflow or underflow. So here this is the truth table that gives the function of the ALU. So we'll first try to write the block diagram of this. As per the question, the block diagram, the ALU will look like this. Say, let me take the module name as ALU itself. It takes 4-bit inputs, 4-bit inputs A and B. So there are two inputs A and B, both of which are 4 bits. Okay, we'll declare them as vectors. So, and 3-bit input signal select. So, there is one input signal named as select. So, we'll take it as select. We better take it as S. It is easy while programming. So, S, which is a 3-bit input signal. And output is a 5-bit output signal named as out. Okay, so it is 5 bit named as out. So once you write the block diagram, it should be straightforward to write the module definition line. Okay, so module definition will be module, name of the module is ALU, and the port list would be out A, B, S. Okay, so now you know output is 5 bit, so it is 4 down to 0 out. Okay, input is 4 bit, 3 down to 0 A comma B. One more input is 3 bit, so it is 2 down to 0 S. Okay, now I'll declare the output as register as well. Okay, to save space I will put this line here only. Output register. Okay, 4 down to 0 out. Now I will this is behavioral modeling, so I will write the always block. The sensitivity list is A comma B comma S, all the inputs. Now inside the big, always block I will just have one case statement. Okay, and the case expression is yes. So based on this values of S, the output should be evaluated accordingly. Okay, so when S is a 3 bit signal, so it should be written as 3 tick B 0 0 0. Okay, colon. If that is the case, output is equal to A. So out equal to A. Okay, 3 tick B 0 0 1. Just look at the truth table. Output is A plus B. Anyways, output is a 5 bit signal and A and B are 4 bit signal. So if there is a carry, it will be taken care of in the 5th bit of out. Okay. Next, 3 tick B 0 1 0. Output is A minus B. Out equal to A minus B. All these are arithmetic expressions. A signal equal to S equal to 0 1 1. For that, output is A divided by B. Okay. Next, 3 tick B 1 0 0. For that, output is given by remainder, that is A modulus B. A modulus B. Then for 101, it is left shift by 1. 101, out equal to A left shift by 1 position. Next, for S equal to 110, output is right shift by 1 position. Okay, and finally for 111, it is a comparator, 3 tick B 111, out equal to A greater than B. So here this is a boolean value. So if A is greater than B, output equal to 1. If A less than B, output will be equal to 0. So end case. Okay, then end for the always block. Then finally end module for the module. Okay, this is how, this is very simple. Whatever whatever expression is given for the different values of select signal in the truth table, that same is to be written as case values and case statements for each case values. Okay, so next is to test this ALU module that we have just designed. Now writing a test bench is not same for all the circuits. It depends on which circuit you have realized. Okay, now here we have realized an ALU. So what you have to do is you have to do one time assignment to this A and B. A and B are the two operands, the numbers that on which the different functions are to be implemented. Okay, so A and B will be one time assignment will be done, and S should traverse through this entire truth table, that is for different values. So you have to apply to S such that you verify all this functionality on A and B. Okay, now we'll proceed to write the truth table, we'll proceed to write the test bench. module ALU test bench empty braces. I will declare the input register 3 down to 0 A comma B and register 2 down to 0 S. Okay. And output is 5 bit, that is 4 down to 0 out, that is declared as wire. Now instantiating the ALU module, let me take it instance name as X1. The order is what we have done in the module definition is out A, B, S, done. Okay. Now inside the initial block, I will do this one time assignment. Initial begin A equal to, I will take it is a 4 bit number, I will take it as random sum value, and B equal to 4 tick B 1010. And yes, I will initialize to something first. Okay, it is a 3 bit number 000. So I have initialized it to this one. Okay, so now what should be the output is, output should be equal to A. Whatever way you have given, that only should be the output. Now, as I've told you, A and B can be left at this, but S should traverse through this truth table. So what I'll do is, I will use this always statement and say hash 10 S equal to S plus 1. Meaning of this is, for after every 10 time units, S will be incremented by 1. That is, initially after 10 time units, S will become 001. That time output should be A plus B. Next, at 20, 010, 30, 011, and so on. Okay. There should be an end for this initial block. And finally, end module. We look at the ALU waveform as per the stimulus block we have written earlier. So if you recall, in the stimulus block, what I have done is I have initialized A to 5 0101 and B to 10 1010. It's a 4 bit number. Okay. And signal S is a 3 bit number. It's a select line for the ALU function. And I've initialized it to 000 here. Okay. So as per the ALU function truth table, for 000, out is equal to A. So A is 0101. So out is 00101. So why this is 5 bit is, we have declared out as a 5 bit vector. Okay. So your 4 bit number will be occupying the lower 4 bits, and the most significant bit will be a 0. Okay, to make up 5 bits. For 001 select line, it is the function is A plus B. So 5 plus 10, it is 15. So 0, 1, 1, 1, 1. Okay. 0, 1, 0, A minus B. A minus B is 5 minus 10. So that is minus 5. So we'll see how it is expressed in 2's complement form. We'll see whether it is correct. 10 minus 5 is 5 minus 10 is minus 5. I'll just see in plus 5 in binary is 0101, right? Minus 5 in binary will be 2's complement of this. So 2's complement of 2's complement of 0101. So 1's complement of 0101 is 1010. Okay. And 2's complement is 1 complement plus 1. 1101. Right. 5th bit is 5th out is the 5 bits. So the same bit only will be extended to make up 5 bits. Hence your A minus B will be 11011. Next is when S is 011, that is A divided by B. So A 5 divided by 10 is 5 divided by 10 is 0. Okay. the quotient will be a fraction, 0 point something. So the whole number is 0 only. Okay. Next 100 is A mod B. A mod B will give you the remainder after division, right? Remainder after dividing A by B. A by B is 5 divided by 10. So quotient is 0, remainder will be 5. Okay. So it is 00101 5. Okay. Next for 101, it is left shift by 1. Left shift by 1. A left shift A by 1. A is 0101. Left shift by 1 means A left shift by 1 means this will be shifted to the left, right? This will be shifted to the left by 1 bit position. So it is 0 1 0 1 0. Okay, 0 1 0 1 0, this one. Okay, 110, it is right shift, again right shift A by 1 bit position. So right shift A by 1 bit position means A is 101, this will be shifted out, this will come to the next right position and so on. So it is 0 1 0 0 0 to make up 5 bits. Okay, so it is 0 0 0 1 0 here. 111, if A greater than B, output will be 1. So A is 5 and B is 10. So A greater than B is false. That's why the output will be 0. Okay. Thank you.